Good morning. Welcome to CATEX TV. My name is Frank Fortunato. Today is Wednesday, October 8th, 2014. You can follow us on Twitter at CATEX TV. The largest storm since Super-typhoon Vong has now formed in the Western Pacific. This would be Typhoon Vong Fong, which has now been classified as a super-typhoon. It has sustained wind speeds of about 155 miles per hour, with gusts of up to 190 miles per hour. The storm is now a Category 4 storm. The central pressure dropped to about 900 millibars, making it the most intense storm of any kind this year. Vong Fong is expected to grow into perhaps a Category 5 storm as it makes its way over warmer waters in the Western Pacific, probably sometime tomorrow. Vong Fong is also expected to follow the same path as Typhoon Fan Fong, which barreled into Japan over the weekend. So we could have a situation where we have a Category 5 storm, the strongest storm of the year, barreling into Tokyo sometime actually late this weekend. A strong earthquake rocked southwest China last night. A 6.0 quake hit the area of Weiyan City in Yunnan province at about 9:49 p.m. Initial reports are that at least 325 people have been injured. One person was killed. The area bordered Myanmar, Laos, and northern Vietnam. Yesterday, it was former Treasury Secretary Tim Geithner's turn down in the Washington, D.C. courtroom, where Maurice Greenberg's Star International company is suing the federal government, seeking more than $25 billion in damages because of an illegal takeover of AIG. This is Mr. Greenberg's theory. Mr. Geithner said that it was necessary for the government to rescue AIG to keep the country from plunging into a second Great Depression. He said a collapse would have induced a mass panic on a global scale. Greenberg's lawyer, the Star litigator David Boies, has sought to portray the government as making ad hoc decisions that unfairly punished AIG, and is arguing that the terms that the New York Federal Reserve Bank imposed upon the bailout, including nearly an 80% stake in the company, were in fact illegal. Air France has successfully renewed its gigantic all-risk insurance program on the same terms as its expiring program. This is a signal that the so-called rate increases in the loss-struck airline market are not going to happen, at least for major safe Western and Asian carriers. Leaders such as Allianz, AIG, and ACE are apparently continuing to fight for rate increases. However, there's evidence that the vast overcapacity in the sector is leading some carriers to individually sacrifice rate increases in exchange for obtaining even more market share. Multiple sources said that the lead insurer on the Air France book, Global Aerospace, which was the only top-tier market to avoid any exposure to the Malaysian air losses, doubled its line on Air France. What seems to be emerging now is a truly differentiated market. The Air France renewal was flat. However, there was a 30% increase for the loss-hit Brazilian carrier Gol Transportes Aéreos, as well as a doubling of the rate for Transasia Airways, and Air India received a 15% increase. So what's happening now is that the carriers that are actually having the losses, the so-called less safe carriers, are being hit harder than the safe carriers, which probably is not necessarily a bad idea. Liberty Mutual is rationalizing its outwards reinsurance for specialty and international business. This is a move that could remove up to $400 million of premium from the reinsurance market, which is not a good thing for the reinsurance business. The Boston-based insurance heavyweight informed its counterparties that it is canceling or non-renewing a slew of treaties across two units, the specialty and international business, reinsuring geographical subsidiaries and business lines internally at the corporate level. So this means that they're going to effectively buy group multi-line retro covers in a strategy aimed at securing balance sheet protection. It's thought that local business units will still be able to buy facultative coverage, but other than that, they will not be able to buy any cover outside of the central treaty purchasing. This strategy replicates what the company's already done over the last few years for its property and casualty book of business. There was a major train derailment in Saskatchewan, Canada, yesterday, near the town of Wadena. prompted authorities to keep people well away from a train that had derailed. The train was carrying hydrochloric acid, caustic soda, as well as petroleum distillates. And the train was 106 cars, 27 cars went off the track, including the locomotive. It's not clear which cars are burning. They're still burning as of right now. People have been moved away. A school was evacuated, as were about 70 people in the area. This all occurred about 230 kilometers east of Saskatoon in Saskatchewan. According to the World Bank, the economic impact of the Ebola outbreak in Western Africa could reach about $33 billion by the end of next year. This is if the Ebola virus, which is ravaging Guinea, Liberia, and Sierra Leone, spreads to other countries in Western Africa. There are two scenarios, said the bank. The impact could be a little bit more than $9 billion if the outbreak is rapidly contained in these three countries, or if it spreads, it could reach about $33 billion. Since it's already spreading and there are cases that have been found in the United States and Spain, as well as in Nigeria and elsewhere, I think the economic outbreak impact will approach about $33 billion. That's the news for today. If we have any breaking news, we'll come back and tell you. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow.